Hello everyone, this is Garrett, and this is Serious Sam HD, The Second Encounter, and we are in the Holy Spirits. And if we walk forward, you hear the boing of something spawning, and that is that person. And I don't want to deal with that person, so instead I'm just going to walk forward and spawn a bunch of other stuff instead. That's way more fun to deal with. Now, you can't actually spawn the bunch of kamikazes without spawning that frog dude with the rockets, but you need to walk a little bit less far forward, and you might as well just spawn him immediately, because he's not too bad, he's not too troublesome, and not so hard to deal with, so I'm just gonna run all the way forward to spawn everything at the same time and end up in a really chaotic situation while watching that chain gun shoot a bunch of people nearby. Now I'm gonna stand here with my knife, like a sneaky person, and sneak up on this arachnoid, and show you that indeed, yes, you can kill things with a knife. And it's oddly satisfying. But more importantly, if you look very closely, I'm not even sure how much this pot shows up in the video, but there's a little red thing, and it's a bullseye, and when you shoot it, it spawns secret ammo. And I'm not even gonna walk all the way there. I can't really be bothered to walk all the way there for some shotgun ammo, because, quite frankly, we're gonna get enough shotgun ammo in this map, so we might as well leave some behind for the next adventure. Instead, I'm gonna move forward, where more shotgun ammo resides in its natural habitat, but not quite here yet. We have to jump on top of the thing. You don't actually need to go up here, but I just like to, because it's an extra thing, and we get to look at the fire, and someone put work in designing that, and you know, I might as well respect the designer's wishes. Sometimes there's like an enemy over here as well, it's kind of hard to see. Oh, okay, whatever. So picking up that shotgun spawns these guys. I think trying to pick up the health will spawn a clear. Oh, I guess the shotgun shells do that as well. Yeah, there he is. He sort of hangs out. He doesn't really do much. Usually he actually tries to run towards you, but this time I guess he wasn't interested or something. Fortunately, the knife is the strongest weapon in the game and takes care of him very well. There he is. There he is. Yeah, like, I don't know what this guy's about, but he just sort of hangs out up here and he doesn't really do a whole lot, but he's an enemy, and you have to kill those. Like, well, he's slime. Let's just move. Let's just ignore him and move on to the Hall of Internet Anger, because this hall has put something in it that made at least two people angry, and probably not much else, because who really gives a crap? But this is a room that has a chainsaw in it, and that's awful, because this is DLC that was based on the first encounter, and the first encounter didn't have a chainsaw, and that, meh, Rogue Team really screwed up on that one. But I disagree. I really enjoy having the chainsaw here, and it actually, I definitely think that the chainsaw improves this level by a million, because you don't really have much of a reason to use the chainsaw in normal gameplay. And it's really satisfying to cut enemies in half in this game, because it looks really cool. Also, there's a lever here. It's really small, but it spawns them. And yeah, there's a couple people that were like, but it's not in the first encounter, and you don't have a chainsaw when you enter the next level that canonically plays after this one. But at the same time, that level would then technically be the Alley of the Sphinxes, because this level takes place after the Metropolis level, when you look at canon stuff. Because I think the story was something along the lines of, oh, the thing we tried to find in Metropolis wasn't there, so we went here instead. And also there's like a Ram God dude, who might or might not be a boss of some sorts, but it's totes just a Ram God or whatever. And the really only important part of that story is that you end up in the Alley of the Sphinxes, because when you end up there, you don't have any ammo. You drop all of everything except for shotgun ammo, so he might as well have dropped his, like, chainsaw as well. Now, this guy sort of spazzes out. If you're lucky, he spazzes out in such a way that he actually just falls off the platform entirely. It doesn't happen very often, unfortunately, but I wouldn't be surprised if when I, like, go outside again that she's gonna hang out somewhere in a place where I don't want her to be. Oh, she's, yeah, she'll manage. I'm just gonna go inside and kill some people with a chainsaw, because even these guys get sawn in half, and it's so much fun. Why would you not want to do this? They even go into the T-pose when you hit them. It's amazing. And there's some people trying to sneak up on us.
Do they really think they can surprise me?
And we can barely hear the voice acting, but it's still cool. And we can move on. But yeah, like, the chainsaw changes the pace of this level by so much, and it actually has, like, reasons to use it, because in normal gameplay, you just have every other weapon instead, and it's like, eh. And it's sort of useful in, like, level 1, but that's really about it. After that, it becomes more of a novelty to use it other than actually being practical. And in this stage, I genuinely believe it is more practical in certain situations than some of the other weapons. Like here, like, I could use a knife, but this is more fun. I get to saw one of those guys, and you don't get to do that in the main game. There'll usually be too many of them, or they'll be stuck on some sort of platform and they just kill you, and it's sad when that happens, and I don't like being sad. I like sawing people in half and being happy. You know, like normal people, but I don't know. Internet people don't like anything. They don't like anything at all. Especially not when something is wrong, and you can't have people being wrong. So there's an arachnoid over there. If you want, you can just shoot it like this, and for the next 5 hours, you will be shooting at it, and it's so much fun, but I'd rather go over here because we actually get to kill some of the extra enemies that spawned in this area. That one's gonna shoot at me, though, and I don't really like that. But there's also one over here. He's in the best position because he's already sort of inside the wall when he spawns, and when he shoots, he pretty much always shoots the wall. It's fantastic. One of the best enemies in the game by far. So there's a bunch of enemies behind me right now, and I don't care. I've got a chainsaw. I'm just gonna saw this dude. Who cares? Chainsaw. I was even jumping on top of that enemy. And he didn't even care. He was like, yeah, sure, use me as a footstool. I can jump on all of these people. That's the cool thing about the HD remake. You can just jump on enemies, and they don't even care. You can just do this, and, you know, it works. It's a fantastic strategy to get anywhere in this game. Wouldn't really recommend it for hard parts, but you can do it when you're fighting like one guy. Or an entire army of Gnars, but we'll leave that for when we get there. So this place can be a bit scary. It's an area that actually goes wrong quite often. And I'm a bit worried about it, but we'll see what happens. I'm not gonna quick save, because quick saving takes too long in this game. I'm just gonna do it. And if I don't do it, you'll just not see this footage. Haha! Video editing. It makes everything make look... It can make everyone look good if you just edit as long as possible. Just spend a little bit longer recording it. But I'm mostly just going to be focusing on the kamikazes here, because there's a fair amount of them. And the other enemies really only serve to hide the kamikazes. Because they don't deal damage. They're not scary. The kamikazes deal 50 damage, and I don't have much armor. So they will deal pretty much the full 50 damage every time, and it's not very fun. And I don't want to have not fun. As I said before, I like enjoying myself. And that includes a chainsaw, but if you chainsaw a kamikaze, you just die, and I don't like... We're going in a circle here. Either way, just grab the chainsaw and kill everyone after you've gotten past that part, because it's mostly the kamikazes that are a danger in that particular area. Because these guys, you can just jump on top of everyone if you want. And even though you hear the sound of someone hitting you, the Gnar's attack animation just makes a sound. That's just what it does. It doesn't care if it hits or not. It just makes noise. And it makes them more menacing that way. And clear skeletons, also pretty cool enemies. And yeah, that one hit me and it deals a lot of damage. They deal 40 damage if you don't have armor, and I don't like it. I don't like it at all. So I'm just gonna move forward because everyone's dead. I don't care about 40 damage. I'm alive, aren't I? Now this next area, it can go wrong, because my strategy is idiotic, but it works, so I'm just gonna do it anyway. We walk forward and hold our chainsaw in front of us, because the thing is... Oh, that was amazing. That was actually somewhat unexpected. The thing is about those guys is that they usually have to wait a while before they can do their melee attack, so usually you just don't take any damage there at all. This time, however, it went a little bit wrong, but we're just gonna ignore that. Usually that goes okay. I guess this time I must have accidentally hit one of the Gnars instead of the green dude, and it hurt. So I'm actually gonna take this next area. A little bit scaredy-pantsy, but it's fine. There's two arachnoids in this place, and I really just went to the wrongest one, because that one's all the way over there. But I'll just take it slow. And this should stun you. Yes, it does. Okay, that's one. Now we just need to take care of the one on the other side, which is currently still shooting bullets at us. I'm genuinely surprised I'm still alive. I'm not gonna lie. This has not gone especially well, but we're just gonna have to take what we can get, and this is what we've been given. Get out of here, you. Oh, and two clears. That's just fantastic. That's exactly what I needed. Oh boy. Get over here. I think the other one's stuck or something. Yeah, it is. Well, that didn't go so bad. Oh, he's still alive. Yeah, all in all, you know, just shoot things and just don't take damage. Pro strats. Just dance around your enemies and hope they choose to dance along and not take the lead. There you go. Battle plans. And I actually completely forgot this area exists, so commentary I said when entering this general sort of dome-ish area was actually meant for the room after this? Yeah, it is. Okay, so a cool thing about this level is that you don't actually need to kill anything for the most part. There's a few areas where you actually have to kill everything. The thing is, like, after you enter this area, it takes a while, but eventually that green dude spawn over there. And with that, it spawns a whole bunch of kamikazes, and I don't really want to deal with those, so I'm just going to leave. Goodbye. Oh, that's interesting. The enemy was actually stuck there. Yeah, the door will close eventually. And we don't have anything more to worry about. Yeah, that's on place for a while. And I'm kind of sorry about that. But, yeah, if I had had more health, which is enough that I didn't need to pick up that 50 health power-up, basically, then I would have actually tried to kill those guys. Pretty much the main strategy there to actually kill those guys is just to stand next to the pillar. Try to make the green guy not see you as much as possible, and he spawns on top of one of those platforms over there. Pretty much the only one that's visible, really. And focus pretty much entirely on killing the kamikazes. Using a shotgun works pretty well. I usually take care of the first couple ones with a pistol, and then afterwards I switch to the shotgun to just try and kill them off, but yeah, no health. So this time instead we're just going to leave them screaming for a while. The annoying thing is that door is deceptively thin. It's actually a bit stupid, and yeah, I was a bit worried about that guy shooting me like he did. And my health would have basically be dead, and I don't really want that. So this door is deceptively thin. And it wouldn't actually surprise me if you could actually just shoot them through the door, because if you walk into the door while they're screaming like that, you will just die. They'll all explode and you're just dead. It's pretty great, actually, but I don't really feel like showing it off. Just take my word for it. You get killed if you die. And it's very it's just unnecessary, really. No, I'm just gonna crawl up here. This little building over here is pretty cool. It has things that speed up the level, actually. In quite a nice way. Because we walk in here, and there's just some gnar, and he's not very cool, but there's this thing. There's like a little patch over here, and if you shoot it, it opens the door, and I'm gonna grab this health while it's opening, because it takes a while. And if you wait a little while, wind starts to go up, and it only shows up for a very short period of time, so I think that if we just sort of jump up here and grab this rocket launcher, which is somehow hiding in this building, the wind is gone, and we can move further down this building where there's another weapon. We just got two weapons in a single building, and they're both pretty cool because the double-barreled shotgun is quite useful against clear skeletons, and we're fighting a lot of those in this level. Also, that guy who I always forget about, but I shot his leg off, so it's okay. It also spawns more of him upstairs, but we have a chainsaw. Gee, I'm sure glad the first encounter had a chainsaw. You guys, makes the world a lot better, more fun. I like fun. I don't, however, like these guys very much, so I'm actually going to take this a little bit slow, because the moment I move closer to that building, it'll spawn a green dude. I don't like them. Like, there's someone behind the door still, and he's still not very happy about what his life has become. But yeah, we move a little bit closer, and that green dude spawned. I'm pretty much going to focus on him for a while, because he's kind of the only one that really deals damage in these parts right now. Eventually it's going to spawn some kamikazes as well, and those are kind of annoying, but mostly I'm worried about that guy. Like, there's a kamikaze to the right of me right now, and this one to the left as well, most likely. Yep, there he is. That one's kind of a jerk, because I think he spawns behind me, and I always just sort of forget about him until it's too late, but it sort of ended up okay. And these purple guys, just they don't really deal much damage if they hit you, and usually, if you just move around, they don't really hit you either, so try to move. Try not to stand still forever, and you'll be fine. Nothing to worry about. And if you do worry a little bit, you can always just grab his health. It's 10 hit points of health right here. Free of charge, and no one's gonna mind if you take it. Everyone's pretty okay with it. They're pretty chill around these parts. And so is that guy. Because he's dead. And therefore, we can move on to the next area. I'm assuming these guys will just keep spawning for a long period of time. There's like 800-something enemies in this level. It's actually a reasonably long level as well. Which is pretty cool, because the DLC only contains 3 levels, so it's nice that 2 of them are pretty long, even though the 3rd one is not so good. It's not the best level, but we'll get there when we get there. Until then, we're just gonna kill kamikazes, and I think I'm just gonna ignore the rest of them, because it's taking too long for my taste. I'm just gonna move forward, grab some health here, grab the shotgun ammo. Like I said, we don't really need that shotgun ammo at the start, because we're getting so much of it. And this area is also another area where things could go wrong. Because there's a fair amount of enemies here. They're not here yet, but they'll get here. I'd rather not move forward too far because I'm pretty sure that spawns a little bit more nastiness. But if you kind of get close to this wall, you hear the pitter-pattering of clear skeletons. And these are complete idiots. Like, most of them are like, oh, we have a route to take. I don't care that our target is right there. We're gonna go forward, wherever forward may be. So most of these are not so much of a problem, and you can take care of most of these just by just sort of standing around here and going, yep, I'm alive. I have a double-barreled shotgun. Nothing is gonna kill me. Because nothing will kill you, because everything is just sort of running. Except for that guy. He knows what he's doing. But for the most part, they all just sort of ran off. And it is something to be aware of, because they do run in a... Well, some of them run in a circle, others just sort of run two directions, is what I'm going to call it. Because I'm not really sure what their goal is when they're running like that, but they are definitely running in directions. So that's, you got to be aware that they don't actually accidentally just all run into you, but eventually their patrol does end and they go towards you, but by then most of them are probably going to be dead, so it's fine. Like, that guy, he's hungry for me, I think, but he's also dead, so who cares? Now, we did pick up a rocket launcher, which could make this area a little bit easier. That guy's just standing still now. Like, what is he doing? It could make the area a little bit easier, but we only get 8 rockets in this level, so I'd rather only use it for when I absolutely need to, and this is not an area where I absolutely need to use a rocket launcher. This is an area where I could probably do it all with a pistol and still be alive, but it's fine. Nothing to worry about. Just be happy that the enemies are complete idiots. Take it for granted. Be happy. You could probably just run to the door immediately. You probably won't even have to fight any of these guys like I did in that previous area. And no one will care. They're fine with it. And that's what I probably should have done. Would have made this level a lot quicker, but I don't care for speed. If I only care about survival. And if an area is too difficult, I'll just run past it. Even when it's not too difficult, I'll just run past it if I feel like it. I can do what I want. Oh, this is actually a bit of a problem. It was almost a problem. But fortunately, kamikazes are not the smartest. They tend to just run straight towards you in this game. At least in this DLC they do, not in the main game. In this DLC they run towards you a lot more than they actually do in the main game. And that's good, because it means you can round them up and have them explode on each other.